Unwrapped is brought to you in part by Cooler Guard with the cleaning power of enzymes, White Rocks Design Studio at Turcotte Design, serving Southern Vermont for over 25 years, P-Line, Corker Boots, Okuma Fishing, Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped Hot Sauce, New England's number one artisan craft-made hot sauce, the Outdoor Experience Guide Service, serving Southern Wisconsin for over 20 years, Razor Rods, make your next rod a razor rod.
Welcome in Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped. I'm your host, Chris Bates, and we are on the road again in Palmyra, Wisconsin, and we are at Rushing Waters, and it's really an interesting place. My friend Dale Helgeson has brought me here, and I am going to talk with Peter Fritsch all about what Rushing Waters is all about.
Yeah, glad you stopped in today.
So, yeah.
Welcome to Rushing Waters. We're right here in southern Wisconsin in the Kettle Moraine State Forest, and we operate a rainbow trout farm here.
Oh, cool. So how in the world did you get started in rainbow trout raising? Or this is a beautiful place. How did this all come about?
Well, thank you. Started with a gentleman named Bill Graham. He purchased his farm in 1994. He was an entrepreneur from the Madison area. And he had this vision of local fish and buy local. I mean, before local was even cool. And I came out of the UW system here in college for fisheries. Wanted to work on a fish farm. He hired me back in 97, made me a partner, and I've been doing this now for 26 years.
Wow. All right. So obviously it grew from a fish farm to a facility that you have here. How did that all come about? Was he in the business of selling fish?
Yeah. In 94, when Bill Graham kind of purchases the farm, he invests some money into it. We put in a brand new processing. You know, everything we're doing here is for food. We're selling to restaurants and retail stores across the country. Mm-hmm. So we would do a new processing so that we're HACCP compliant, FDA ready to go. The store right here that you just saw, we got the outlet store, and we've been just kind of growing ever since.
So tell me a little bit about the trout. How is that done? Like, obviously you get eggs, or do you have your own brood stock? How does that all work?
Great question. So right now we're buying fertilized eggs.
Okay.
We had our own brood stock. A lot of tricks and things there. Still fun, but right now we buy our own eggs. We hatch on site. We've got two hatcheries.
Oh.
So from the time we get those eggs in, we hatch them, feed them, grade them, all the way up to we harvest them, and then you can buy them in the store. They never leave our control. We're complete control of these animals.
So how long does it take then? So from the time you get the fertilized eggs, how do they come in? I'm just curious.
It's actually kind of fascinating. There are fertilized eggs called eyed eggs. They come on ice, FedEx box. So they get shipped from another hatchery out on the West Coast.
Okay.
And they just come on ice. We put them in trays, and that starts the process to about 15 to 16 months before you'll see them at a restaurant or they leave our place.
Okay, so there are stages, obviously, and you have rearing ponds, and is that available to see?
Yep, we're going to go down and give you a tour in a little bit.
Right.
56 ponds on site, So wow. They go from a hatchery to little ponds, and then as they get bigger, they go to our harvest ponds.
And how many people do you have that run the hatchery and all this? How many people operation is this?
We've got 30 employees right now with 6 dedicated farmers. And then we've got our team of processing, you know, delivery drivers, accountants, office staff.
Yeah, yeah.
And then whatever I do around here as well. So.
Wow. I'm fascinated by it because, you know, I love rainbow trout fishing. I love brook trout fishing. And I love brown trout fishing. And coming from the east, this is like right up my alley. Even though, you know, they're farm raised, it's still the same. It's a fish.
Yeah, and they're gorgeous fish. And we're so proud of our fish. You're going to see it. I mean, all natural earthen ponds are outside. There's weeds, there's algae, there's insects. These fish are as close to a native trout
wow.
as you're gonna get. And that's part of what we're so proud of. No chemicals, no antibiotics, no hormones, no nothing. These fish are just the way nature intended.
So I think that's part of the fascination for me is that, you know, they're not pellet fed, so to say. They might be supplemented with something, but for the most part, they're able to eat bugs and whatever else is out there.
Yeah, these have full access to Mother Nature's. So yes, we obviously do have a pellet diet.
Well, right, right.
But super good, really, I mean, it's you are what you eat. You've heard that.
Right.
So again, with our diet, I mean, it's premium.
Now, how big do you have these fish come to market at, you know, a pound, 2 pounds, 4 pounds?
A little bit smaller, about a pound and a quarter, just over a pound. 16, 18 ounces, you know, that's a good portion size.
So I see.
That 16-ounce fish can be a boneless 8 to 10-ounce portion that will go to a restaurant. So that's what really drives the market for us. And then we've got an automatic fillet machine that can make quick work out of
it. Oh, come on, I got to see that. That is...
When you're doing thousands of fish a day, you got to have...
That's amazing.
You got to have a machine.
Yeah. So a lot of times, too, people always tell me, well, what does trout taste like? And I'm like, well, I have nothing to compare it to. I said, it just tastes good. And they say, well, what color is the flesh? Why do people ask that question? And you get that a lot.
Oh, yeah. That's a great question. So a lot of your wild trout in the wild, they're going to have that pinkish-reddish hue.
Right.
They get that from eating the crustaceans and the anaxanthin that's naturally found in those things.
Mm-hmm.
Our fish are about the color of your palm. It's a light pink. You know, they get a pellet diet, but then they get that also extra insects that are
right.
in the pond.
Right.
So we don't add any dyes or any colorants to our fish food. It's kind mm-hmm. of a natural color.
Got it.
But they're wonderful.
Gosh. And what strain is it? Are there different strains yes. of rainbow trout? Because I see some that they say just trout. And to me, they look very close to a rainbow trout, but I don't ever really see the stripe in it. So
yeah.
What is that type of deal?
So what we're raising, so there's the, you know, when does a trout become a steelhead?
Oh, right, so, right, right, right.
So there's steelhead strains and there's can loop strains.
Oh.
And we're raising both.
Okay.
And, you know, they all look pretty similar. It's hard to tell them apart.
Right, because, you know, when I go to the grocery store and I see trout, I'm like, is that really a rainbow trout or what is that? Because you can't even see the faint
yeah.
stripe in it, but you should be able to even after it's been on ice.
Yeah, and you'll see that on our fish.
Yeah.
It's not as vibrant as you might see in some of the wild fish.
Right, right.
But ours are pretty prevalent. More
wow.
than you're going to see at the average trout in the store.
Right, right. All right, well, I can't wait to go see the place. It's
Looking
great. Thank
it.
You so much for spending some time with us, and it's going to be a fun time. All right, folks, we're going to be right back with more after this.
Hi, I'm Brian Hoosier from Baitbox on the Rock, and you're watching Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped.
Let this bad boy go, but wow, look at that fish.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Wow. The Outdoor Tip of the Week is brought to you in part by Razor Rods. All American, all the time. Make your next rod a Razor Rod.
Hi, Dale Helgeson here with your Outdoor Tip of the Week. Today we're going to talk about crawler harness, one in particular. This is by Walleye Nation Creations, and it's called the Death Harness. And what it does is, not only do you have your spinner blade, you have a treble hook with a swivel, and it has a death hook on it. So I'm going to show you how to hook this up. Because death hooks are a little different, and this death harness is a little different yet. So I usually leave a little tag end of the crawler, and I thread it onto the death hook. So you thread the death hook until it's almost all the way up to the top, and I pop it through the hook just a touch. And you want this to be at about a 90 degree angle, because this thing you want to rotate in the water. And then you take the treble hook and you just pop it through the top of that crawler. So you can either run a whole crawler, or if you have really long crawlers, you may want to, or if you get a lot of short bites, you're going to want to pinch a little bit off the end of this so you don't get those short bites and you get them on the hook. When this thing runs in the water, this crawler will actually rotate too. It'll corkscrew in the water as well as your spinner blade spinning. So, and that is your outdoor tip of the week.
Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped is brought to you in part by Razor Rods, all American, all the time. Make your next rod a razor rod.
Hey, welcome back to Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped. We are at Rushing Waters here in Palmyra, Wisconsin, and we're with Pete. And we're going to talk about, where are we now on the property?
So we are standing down here just outside of our hatchery. We've got in the background right here one of our harvest ponds. We just stocked it with about 14,000 8-inch fish.
Wow.
And they'll stay in there for about the next 4 months until they reach probably 11 inches, and then we'll start pulling the bigger ones out for harvest.
Uh-huh. So what kind of water is it? Is it spring water from the ground? You know, how do you keep the water going?
Yeah, so that's the beauty. So right here in Palmyra, Wisconsin, we have arguably some of the best water in the country. So we are right here where the glacier ran out of steam.
Oh.
So literally a half mile of ice right here. The Kettle Moraine State Forest is that terminal moraine.
Oh.
The weight of the ice cracked the limestone underneath us. So we are right on some major springs. And then we can drill into that limestone and get artesian pressure. So we have natural springs and we have artesian wells, giving us beautiful 50 degree year-round ice cold water.
I was just going to ask that. So rainbow trout, what is their comfort level for water? Like, they can't go below this, or they can't go above this?
I mean, they'll survive right down, you know, just above freezing, but they're not going to eat. They're not going to do much. They kind of just sit there.
Right.
So ideally, you want these fish between 50 to 58 degrees is like the beautiful temperature for them. Keeps it comfortable, good dissolved oxygen in the water.
I see.
And we're right there. So we're able to give them their ideal water temperature.
And I see that you have, are they aerators? Is that what they are? They're aerators? You have aerators so it doesn't freeze?
Well, the water won't freeze. It stays warm enough. But you want to have the aeration just for extra dissolved oxygen.
Oh, I see.
You know, we're running these fish, obviously, more than a natural carrying capacity.
Got it.
So the little supplemental air really helps them stay happy.
I get it. And how do you know how many fish you can put in each pond?
That's a great question. And to be honest, it just comes with experience.
Oh, okay.
Been doing this so long, you learn how many fish you can put in a pond. And it's not how many, it's how big they are and their biomass. You know, I could have one fish in here that weighed, you know, 4,000 pounds.
Right.
Or I could have 4,001-pound fish.
I got it.
So you just kind of learn where your biomass is.
You know, this is really interesting for me because, you know, a lot of people are always curious about what really goes on, you know, what really is it? Now, is there any difference really farm-raised, wild? Is there really a big difference?
Well, you just hit the big, that's a like five more segments of your show.
Okay.
Wild versus farm, but I'll tell you, at the end of the day, what's the big difference for you, for your health?
Right.
Eating seafood, eat seafood, live longer, it's good for you. You know, that I think everyone finally agrees on.
Right.
They're both good. I love wild salmon, for example, out of Alaska.
Right.
It's a big part of our business up here. I love farm-raised salmon. It can be done right. You got to know your source. It's like anything else, from tomatoes to steaks. You got to know your source.
Right.
And when you're doing something the way we're doing it here, all natural, without anything, that's done right. You can't argue it.
Yeah, you can't.
So, same thing with wild. There's some wild species that aren't done right. You know, they're either over-harvested or something like that. So
yeah.
As long as you do the homework, and our consumers nowadays are much more educated, they're making good choices.
Yeah.
They're weeding out the bad farms or the bad wild choices.
So, right.
So today, you're hearing a little bit less and less of that
That's true. That is absolutely true. And, you know, and I'm just looking around. I can already tell. I've been in this business a long time. I could tell that it's really run really good.
Yeah, I mean, these fish, you know, again, keeping the fish happy and healthy.
Yeah.
It's number one goal. These fish, up until the day of their process here on site, we're taking good care of these fish.
And you also have a fishing pond. How is the fishing pond available?
So we have a fishing park, so to speak. We keep one pond on the property. We think it's really important for us to stay back to our roots. I mean, hunters and gatherers, you know,
right
in our past. It's in our genes.
You know it.
So we have a park. We have the fishing, the gear. We have everything you need. You come on out. You don't pay for anything unless you catch fish.
Okay.
You catch them. We clean them for you. Put them on ice. Send you home with recipes.
Wow.
It's a way to enjoy, you know, activities in nature and put food on your table.
Wow. All right. Well, this is a great part of the show. I'm really like that. So we got to see some other stuff about the fish, right?
You got to watch me feed them.
Yeah, we do. So, okay. Let's go. Let's go do it.
If you got a lot of love and you don't know where to put it.
Welcome back to Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped. I'm having such a great time out here at the
Rushing Waters.
Rushing Waters. And we're now in the retail shop, which there's all kinds of cool stuff, and we're going to learn all about what's in the shop. So when you're here, make sure you stop here, check it out, okay? All right, so Pete, what do we have in the case?
All right, here's a typical day. What we've got is on this end here, we've got our fresh. We do bring in farm-raised Atlantic salmon that we smoke here.
Yeah.
Here's our trout right here from the ponds. These were cut this morning. So we got our fresh butterfly trout. Then we move on to our fully cooked.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got our trout fillets that we smoke. And then we've got salmon jerky. It's a new product. It's actually really, really good. And then we've got four flavors of the hot smoked Atlantic that we're currently offering today. We've got a pineapple citrus, a lemon dill, a Cajun, and then our traditional hickory smoked. All smoked right here in our plant.
Wow. So what is the crowd favorite? What do people really come and
So the smoked trout has made us pretty famous. I mean,
right.
that's something that, you know, born and raised on site and smoked right here. That has always been one of the most famous things. And then, again, the traditional hickory smoked salmon is probably number two. You know, it's kind of like even on ice cream. Vanilla and chocolate are your best sellers. But the salmon jerky, it's new. Been playing with that for about a couple months. And it's really something that's good.
We'll have to try some before we leave. All right, and I love smoked trout too. I smoke my own as well, and you're right, you can't go wrong.
It's just a nice, delicate flavor, and again, it's something that, you know, when you hatch them from egg and you're behind it the whole way, it's really rewarding to be here and then get all the compliments about how good it is.
Right. All right, so now you have another case over here. This is just your...
Yeah, we've got some, you know, again, it's Wisconsin, so you got to have cheese and sausage. It's a law here.
Right.
And then one of our really popular items is our smoked rainbow trout spread.
Mm.
This is a cream cheese-based spread, ready to eat. Put it on a cracker or a bagel.
Yeah.
These are phenomenal. And again, all of our products, you can buy them online, rushingwaters.net.
Okay. And you got a phone number? We can talk about your phone number.
Yeah, if you can give us a call, 262-495-2089.
All right.
But these gifts are great. You know, the holidays is always our busiest time for shipping. But then you look at this. This is a Neapolitan. This is one salmon fillet with pepper, plain, and lemon dill.
That's a cool way to package it.
So that's that's our gift box
here. Yeah, you get little bit of everything.
Tells our story. So.
Yeah. Wow. Okay, and then you come over here in the center, and?
Well, we've got everything else you need. You know, we got some sauces. We've got our different condiments, some jellies, some crackers.
Yeah.
Again, we really focus on a lot of Wisconsin things, Bloody Mary mix and toffee.
Yeah,
all made right here in Wisconsin. So
that's awesome.
That's what our little store is really known for.
And then you have a freezer with stuff as well.
Yep, then we've got your shrimp and lobsters, and we do a Alaskan salmon burger that we also sell. So we're a full line seafood store.
It's a nice little place
to stop.
Yeah, and you got some clothing here that people probably go, wow, because I was drawn right away to that hat with the rainbow, and I was like, wow, what a cool logo. So
yeah, well, good, thank
you. All right, well, why don't we take a quick break? We'll come back, and I think I'm going to go try to catch a fish. We'll be back with more right after this. Welcome back. We are finally to the point of what I'm really gonna like. Fishing for trout. Pete, what's the deal?
So this is it. This is our fishing pond. As you can see, it's pretty well stocked. This probably looks like a lot of your rivers back home in Vermont.
Oh yeah.
This is light for the Wisconsin rivers
right
here. So anyway, this is where the families come down. Whatever you catch, you gotta keep, and then we do the filleting for you. So when you're ready, we'll see if you can do it.
So, hey everybody, I am using a Zebco?
Zebco 202.
202, and let's talk about the rules of coming here fishing.
Yeah, no catch and release. Whatever you catch, you gotta keep.
Right.
You know, once you handle the trout, we'd rather have you bring it up.
Okay, but the equipment.
Oh yeah, you can't bring your own equipment, you gotta use our equipment.
Right.
Just for biosecurity, we don't know where your equipment's been.
Correct. So
I
sometimes say, why are you bringing that in my Vermont waters? I don't want that, right? Okay, so I'm using the Zebco, a bobber, a worm. We all know about that, a red worm, which is our favorite bait for brook trout, by the way. And we are gonna see what we do here. Push the button, right?
Push the button in, yeah.
Okay.
And then you gotta let it go.
Okay. I'm letting her go. Oh boy. The bobber's going down, everybody. Oh, there he is. He's,
take him.
I can't reel.
Oh, no. You got to reel.
Okay.
There we go.
All right, everybody.
There we go. We're on.
Holy cow. We're on. Here we come.
Get the net.
Get the net.
Hey, look at that.
All right, everybody. If you're ever in Palmyra, Wisconsin, you got to come here. All right, we'll see you all next time.
Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped is brought to you in part by Cooler Guard with the cleaning power of enzymes, White Rocks Design Studio at Turcotte Design, serving Southern Vermont for over 25 years, P-Line, Corker Boots, Okuma Fishing, Outdoor Secrets Unwrapped Hot Sauce, New England's number one artisan craft-made hot sauce. The Outdoor Experience Guide Service, serving Southern Wisconsin for over 20 years. Razor Rods, make your next rod a razor rod.
We'll meet you again. May God bless you. Adios.
Wise men say, only fools rush in. But I can't fall in love.